The Holy Bible says that Peter was grieved because he said unto him the third time, "Lovest thou me?" Something was beginning to happen to Peter. Something was beginning to happen on the inside. Y'all say amen. You know, something was beginning to happen. Now they have a common, everyday conversation, and already the man is about to break into tears. You know something has happened in that conversation. Not only in the conversation, but something is happening in Peter. Look, the Lord Jesus is all right. Y'all say amen. Jesus ain't got no problem. Peter got the problem. Y'all say amen.
Amen.
Something was beginning to happen to Peter. Something was beginning to happen on the inside of Peter. Something was beginning to cut Peter's heart wide open, if you will, and if you please. I mean, come on, y'all. Y'all know just having a conversation with somebody, and all of a sudden somebody starts bursting in tears. You know something's happening in that conversation. Now, you may not be able to pick it up, but you know something just happened in that conversation. Jesus was beginning to break through Peter's brass and bone exterior. Amen, somebody. It was no accident that Jesus chose Peter out of the apostolic band to have this very personal conversation with. And you got to, you know, and you got to admit, that's a personal situation, you know, right there. When somebody asks you to your face, "Do you love me?" That's a personal situation, y'all. I don't know, y'all ain't gonna yet. That's personal. You ever had anybody ask you, "Do you love me?" I mean, ask you to your face, you know, not send you a note. Not sitting by me, just y'all just standing there face to face, and somebody asks you, "Do you love me?" That's a personal situation.
Yeah.
Amen, somebody. That's
amen.
That's a not a personal situation. That's a one-on-one situation. You know? That's an eyeball-to-eyeball situation. That's a heart-to-heart situation. That's a chest-to-chest and a breast-to-breast situation. Amen, somebody. It is no accident that Jesus chose to direct this challenge to Peter.
Amen.
It is no coincidence that Jesus asked Peter three times, "Lovest thou me more than these?" Peter denied that he ever knew the Lord three times. Y'all say amen. So maybe right about up in here, I'm just interjecting. It looks like about right back up in here, since Peter denied Jesus three times, look like Jesus right now, right up in here, is checking on Peter. Y'all say amen. You know, amen, because they said he loved him, but when he needed him most, y'all say amen.
Amen.
Yeah. No coincidence. Both Peter and Jesus is alive to remember Peter's promotion of self. I hope somebody heard that one right there. And his denial of the Savior. Both of them are alive. Amen, somebody. And you know how it is when somebody done you wrong, and they know that they done you wrong, and you know that they done you wrong. And you know, if you don't have to see that person, y'all say amen. If you don't have to see that person, I'm talking about after you done them wrong. That's what I'm talking about.
Amen.
Or somebody done you wrong, y'all say amen. And you know, and you don't have to see one another. You can just about get by that situation without your conscience hurting you too bad. Y'all say amen.
Amen.
But when you got to see one another face to face, when you got to see
you get baptized today, Kylie.
That changes the dynamic of the situation. Notice as well that Jesus addressed Peter by his full name. And you need to understand what's happening here. You know what's happening when somebody addresses you by your full name, you know, in everyday conversation. Y'all say amen. You know what's happening when somebody addresses you by your full name in common everyday conversation. That means that they're really trying to get your attention. Amen, somebody. That means they really are saying something they really want you to hear. And it was the last time that Peter heard Jesus address him by his full name. It's in Matthew chapter number 16 and verse 13 through 18. Y'all remember, I didn't know about it before tonight, but y'all remember the Bible says when Jesus came into the coast of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, saying, "Whom do men say that I, the Son of Man, am?" And they said, some say that thou art John the Baptist, and some say that thou art Isaiah, and some say that thou art Jeremiah, or one of the prophets. But the Bible says Jesus turned word to the disciples and said, whom do ye say that I am? And Peter was the one who spoke up, and he said that thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. And then Jesus said unto him, blessed art thou, Simon Bar-Jonah, son of John. Simon, son of John. The last time that Peter heard him address him like that was when Peter acknowledged or admitted that Jesus was the Christ, the Son of the living God. But here Jesus is again, and every day, in everyday conversation, people don't normally address you by your whole name. Amen. But here he is now again, addressing him by his whole name. He said it three times too. Simon, son of Jonas, or son of John, lovest thou me more than this. He uses his first name, addressing him by his first name, because he really has something that he wants to say to Peter. He really has something that he wants Peter to get an earful of. Amen, somebody. This child is parallel, of course, the apostles, Peter's failure, and it's no coincidence that Jesus asked him three times, because he denied him three times. Y'all say amen. Yeah. Under all circumstances, if you ask me, this was a dynamic situation unfolding. I mean, I believe that this conversation, this communication with the Christ, comes to Peter like an emotional tidal wave from the very first time, the very first word that dripped out of the master's lips. I mean, here he is addressing him by full name in everyday common conversation. Then you might remember Jesus was heard to say, it is written, I will smite the shepherd, and the sheep shall scatter. And Peter was the first one to speak up, though all would deny you. I will not deny you. I will even die for you. That's what Peter said. That's what he said. That's what it said. That was Peter's, I'm not like the rest of them statement. Y'all say amen. That was Peter's, I'm better than they are statement. Y'all say amen. And it was in the Bible, right? My pride cometh before the fall. Amen, somebody. He that thinketh that he stands, think he, lest he falls. Y'all say amen. And that's why I've heard this before. I've said this many times over the years. Sister Mark, I think I've heard this from anybody else. So this must be a Clifton creation. That's what that must be. But that's why I say, you know, you heard the Bible just say the pride coming before the fall. You know the Bible, I know. And then the Bible says, you know, he that thinketh that he stands, take heed lest he fall. And that's why I always have to say that we should always walk as close to the ground as we can, so that when you fall, y'all say amen, amen, you won't have so far to go. Amen. Don't be walking all up on the clouds and yeah, amen, nose all up in the air. Close as you can on the ground, so that when you fall, it ain't if you fall, y'all say amen. You're going to fall one time before you leave there. It ain't if. It's when you fall, you won't have that far to go. And if you don't mind, let me just check this real fast. I like what Les Brown said. He said, if you fall, he says, I hope you fall on your back, because if you can look up, you can get up. Amen. So if you don't mind, I'll throw that in there while I'm in the neighborhood. If you fall, I hope you fall on your back. Because if you can look up, you can get up. Amen, amen, somebody. Amen. Yeah, but we know the record, don't we? We know the record. Now remember what Peter just said. Remember this conversation they're having. Remember what Peter had done to Jesus. Y'all say amen. This conversation. Y'all remember what happened? And that is, he denied that he even knew the Christ. And here they are right now. We remember the record. And that's what it said. He said, Lord, he said, though everybody would deny you, I ain't going to do it. He said, Lord, though everybody would deny you, he said, I'll even die for you. Let alone talk about denying, I'll die for you. We know the record. Jesus enters the master's presence with an armed contention. Jesus steps forward to them, and I think I like this, because Jesus asked them, who are you looking for? And the Bible said, they fell backwards. They fell down on the ground. And y'all say amen right up in there. You know why? Because, you know, normally when you're going after somebody, you don't expect them to, you know, you don't expect them to come forward. You expect them to be backing up. But Jesus, Judas enters the heart of, the devil enters the heart of Judas. Judas comes with an armed contention. As they approach Jesus, Jesus stepped forward and say, who are you looking for? And they say, we're looking for Jesus. He said, I'm Jesus. And they back up and fall down. Amen, somebody. The Bible said, while they were down on the ground, Jesus said, who are you looking for? And they said, we look at what Jesus already told you. I'm him. Let the rest of these folk come and get on with your business. Amen.
We know here Peter is in that garden there where they came to get him. And to Peter's credit, now if you don't mind, Peter started out wanting to fight for the Lord. Y'all say amen. Amen. I mean, y'all remember that sword incident? They pulled that sword out, and the Bible said, I don't know how he cut that man's ear off. I don't know what he did. But the Bible says he cut Malchus's ear off, and I wasn't there, and I don't know what happened. I don't know if Jesus reached down. Y'all say amen. Amen. I don't know. I got some stuff for the bed. But I don't know if Jesus reached down and picked up the man's ear, or because he was God. Y'all say amen. Jesus put that man's ear back on his head, that Jesus looked right into that man's eyes, and not only looked right into that man's eye, but looked past that man's eye and looked down into the bottom of that man's soul. And for 1 minute, Brother Johnson, that man is his maker. Y'all say amen. I wouldn't hear anybody else say it happened like that. And I just imagine that for 1 second, that man met his maker like he never had before. Because by Jesus put that ear back on his head. Jesus looked not into it, only into his eyes, but looked through his eyes. And looked down at the bottom of his soul. he been making that day. Amen, somebody. Yeah, we know the record. We know what happened. That's what happened. He tried to fight him. You know what Jesus told him? Jesus told him, put up his sword. I don't need you to fight for me.